This video is going to be an introduction to function notation. So let's see what that's all about. Here I've got two equations. You're used to seeing things like this. I've got y equals 3x plus 5, and y equals x squared minus 2x. Now, if I want to deal with both of these equations at the same time, and I want to talk about them, I'd have to either let you know which one I mean by reading the whole equation, or by saying the first equation and the second equation. And if I had more equations, like another y equals something and yet another one, I'd have to talk about the third equation and the fourth equation. So this gets kind of clumsy at times. What we're going to do is we're going to give names to each of the equations. And the names are going to be letters. So the first equation, y equals 3x plus 5, I'm going to use an f for that one. And what I'm going to write is f, and then in parentheses, I'm going to put the x, and then equals whatever that y used to equal, 3x plus 5. So if y equals 3x plus 5, and f of x, this is read as f of x, equals 3x plus 5, then y must equal f of x, this first y. Now I'm going to take the second equation and give that a different name, basically a different letter. So I could call that g. So this is going to be read as g of x equals, and then I'll just copy what the old y used to equal, x squared minus 2x. And now I can talk about function f and function g. Now I could have any letters I want instead of f and g, just like you can have letters instead of x and y. Typically, when we've got no reason to do anything differently, we start out with the letter f, and then if we have another function, we'll call that g. The one after that might be h, and so on. Okay, so the first use for function notation is it allows you to tell which equation you're talking about, which function you're talking about, either the f function or the g function. Now, there's another nice thing about this. Let's take that first one, f of x equals 3x plus 5. If instead of that I had used the y equals 3x plus 5, and I wanted to know what happens when x is 2, I would have to say evaluate y when x equals 2. Well, a faster way to do that with function notation is to replace the x in the f of x with whatever I want x to equal. So if I write f of 2, then what that means is I'm going to find out what 3x plus 5 is when instead of having an x, I have a 2. So all I'll do is put that 2 in wherever I have an x on the right side of my function. So that's going to be 3 times 2 plus 5. And then, of course, when I multiply that out, I'll have 3 times 2 is 6, and 6 plus 5 is 11. Now, it can get even fancier than that. Let's say I take function g. So function g was g of x equals x squared minus 2x. And if I want to know what that function is when x equals, I don't know, let's say 5, I'll just write g of 5, and I'll take each of my x's in the right side of the function notation, and I'll replace it with a 5, whatever I have in parentheses here after the name of my function. So that means I'm going to have 5 squared minus 2 times 5. Well, let's see. 5 squared is 25. And 2 times 5 is 10. So g of 5 equals 15. Let's try one a little more complicated than that. Let's say that instead of having the x, I want to say, what would happen if the x was bigger? What would happen if every x was bigger by 2? So in other words, I want to find out what happens when instead of x, I've got x plus 2. So I'm going to write g of x plus 2, and let's see what that equals. Well, that means instead of the x squared that I have, I'm going to take that whole x plus 2, and I'll square it. And then I'm going to subtract 2 times x plus 2. And I'll work this out. So let's see. X plus 2 squared means that's x plus 2 times x plus 2 minus 2 times x plus 2. So that means I've got to FOIL the first two binomials here. So I'm going to have x times x is x squared. X times 2 is 2x. I've got a 2 times x, that's another 2x. 2 times 2 is 4. Then I'm subtracting, so I'll distribute this 2. 2 times x is negative, well, it's negative 2x. And the negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. And then when I combine all my like terms, I'm going to have x squared. I've got a 2x and a 2x and a minus 2x. Well, the minus 2x will cancel out one of the 2x's. So I'll have x squared plus 2x. And then I've got a positive 4 and a negative 4. So they'll cancel each other out. And I'm going to get x squared plus 2x. So g of x plus 2 equals x squared plus 2x. Okay, so just reviewing this. I'm using function notation so I can tell the difference between different equations that I have. I'm naming the equations, and I'm naming them with letters, like the letter F or the letter G, or whatever letter I want. So for the first equation, basically I'm saying that F of x is the same as y. And for the second equation, I'm just saying that g of x is the same as y, so I just replace one with the other. Then I can use function notation to find out what that function would equal if I replace the x with something more specific, either a number or some variation on the x, like x plus 2. Okay? So that's basically all that's going on here. It's a little bit hard to get used to at first, but just do a bunch of exercises, and after a while, it becomes more or less second nature. Okay, that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.